Welcome to another short video on imaging in nuclear medicine. In today's video, we will talk about the famous maximum likelihood expectation maximization algorithm and its application to image reconstruction. As a small recap, remember that in the last video, we talked about the concept of maximum likelihood reconstruction. And we saw that the maximum likelihood reconstruction is actually or means that we optimize the log likelihood of all measured data y given an image lambda, which is actually the same as optimizing the log likelihood of the image lambda given the data y and assuming that the likelihood of all possible reconstructions lambda is the same, or constant. And then we've also seen if the measured data y follows a Poisson distribution and if we have a linear model that tells us how to basically map from the image lambda to the expectation of the measured data y, then we can write the log likelihood as this function here. And finding the maximum likelihood reconstruction means actually finding the argmax of that function here. And the naive way to do that would be just to say, okay, we know that in an optimal point, all the partial derivatives with respect to all the lambda j's have to vanish, so we can force them to be zero. But we've also seen that the problem is that in real life, the number of unknowns, so the number of lambda j's is huge. That's usually up to a million. So we get a million of equations, they're all coupled. And unfortunately, also non-linear in the unknowns. So you can see that here. Solving that huge system of coupled equations is unfortunately impossible. But actually, there is an algorithm called maximum likelihood expectation maximization, and it's based on the concept of expectation maximization. And this algorithm is actually an iterative algorithm. So that means we don't get basically a one-step solution, but we find the maximum likelihood solution in an iterative way. So basically by updating our solution step by step. And the update formulas shown here in the red box, I won't explain all the sums and all the details right now because we will do that in a more graphical way in a second. Proving this update scheme actually converges to the maximum likelihood solution is not trivial, and it's definitely beyond the scope of that video. But if you're interested in the proof, I can recommend those three articles, so the ones by Lange and Carson, Schepenwardi and Demstalard and Rubin. So all the mathematics and the rigorous proof is in there. So instead of writing the update formula with all these sums, so basically the sums are necessary to write out those matrix vector products for the, so there's a matrix vector product here for the forward model and then also here in the backward steps. We can also use vector and operator notation. So instead of, as I said, writing the forward model with a sum over the system matrix elements, I can also say I define the system matrix as an operator C or a matrix C. And then I'm just saying, okay, my vector of expected measurements is the operator C applied to the vector lambda plus the vector of contaminations. And if I use that notation, I can also rewrite the MLM updates using operator notation, which looks like this. So again, we have a pointwise division of two vectors, and then we have to apply the adjoint of our system matrix. We have to apply the adjoint of the system matrix to a vector of 1, and then we finally have to update our image. But instead of looking at formulas, let's try to understand the MLM update recipe in a more graphical way. To do that, I've prepared a short simulated toy example. So let's say we have a scanner that has measured a set of projection data, and I have just reorganized the measured projection data into what's called a cyanogram, but it actually doesn't really matter how you organize your data. But say this is our measured data, y. And to find the maximum likelihood reconstruction, what we do is we first have to actually guess a reconstruction, or we have to choose a starting point. And as a starting point, I've just shown a very blurry image, so basically a blob, more or less a homogeneous blob. And the first state in the MLM update is to apply our forward model to our current image estimate. So this is basically this step here. So we calculate the vector y bar as a function of our current image lambda, which gives us also a cyanogram, or we can again display the estimated data as a cyanogram. And then in the next step, what we do is we build a ratio between the measured data and the expected data. And this is basically an element-wise division of those two vectors, which gives us another cyanogram, which is actually this term here. Then we apply the adjoint of our system matrix C to back project that ratio cyanogram. That gives us an image again. Then we have to calculate this term here. So this is a back projection of a cyanogram full of ones. Gives us what is usually called the sensitivity image. And note that this term is actually constant over all updates, so we can just keep that in memory. And then what I've shown here is actually this is the ratio of the back projected ratio cyanogram and the sensitivity image. So this is actually all this here, which is also an image, and you can see that as a multiplicative update image. And finally, we multiply that update image to our input image, which results in our updated image. And this is applying one MLM update. And then actually we just start over again. So we insert the updated, or we just see the updated image as our current image again. We apply the forward model again, which gives the expected data. We calculate the ratio cyanogram again, the back projected ratio. We divide by the sensitivity image, and we multiply it to our input, which gives us the updated image. So this is the second MLM update. And we can, of course, continue and continue. So this would be update 3, update 4. This would be 10 updates, 50 updates, 100 updates, 200 updates, 500 updates, 1,000 updates. And you can see after 1,000 updates, you can see our multiplicative update image is actually one everywhere, or very close to one everywhere. And actually the updated image is almost the same as the input image. So we are converged. You can also see that the ratio of the two cyanograms is very close to one almost everywhere, except here in the background region, and this is due to actually a bit of noise in the data. So you can see the measured data here actually would correspond to a high count scan, or to a very long scan with high activity. So we have almost no noise on the measured data. So just again to show you that MLM actually converges, as I said, if you read those three papers, you can already show that MLM has proven convergence to the maximum likelihood solution. MLM also leads to a monotonic increase of the log likelihood. That means with every update, the log likelihood increases a bit, so you come closer to the maximum likelihood solution. And what you can also show is that actually low frequencies in the image converge faster than high frequencies. Moreover, there are a few other properties of MLM, like that the convergence is object dependent, but we won't go into those details in this video. Okay, unfortunately, realistic data in nuclear medicine is never noise free. So we actually always have quite a lot of noise on our data. So what happens to the noise in the data? How is that transferred during MLM? So to visualize that, I've shown you MLM reconstructions after different updates. So after 50 updates, after 100 updates, 500 updates, and 1,000 updates. And we're starting with a relatively, or with a scan that has collected many counts, so 10 to the power of 8 counts. You can see the cyanogram here, there's almost no noise on the cyanogram. And you can see indeed, if we iterate longer and longer, we can see that the resolution of our reconstruction gets better and better. We can also see that there's a bit of noise that gets introduced into the maximum likelihood solution, but since there's not a lot of noise in our data, also the noise in our maximum likelihood solution is very low. And actually the maximum likelihood solution is kind of close to the true image that I used to simulate the data. If you want to suppress the noise a bit, of course, one strategy what you can do is you can post smooth the image. So of course after, like, I can take the solution after 50 updates and I just smooth it with a Gaussian filter. I've done it here with a filter of 4.5 millimeters. Of course, I can also do that for the reconstruction after 1,000 updates. Of course, if we apply smoothing, we see that we suppress the noise a bit, but of course, we also lose a spatial resolution. Okay, so what happens if we decrease the number of collected counts by a factor of 10? So instead of having 10 to the 8, we have now 10 to the 7. So first of all, you can see that we start seeing actually noise in the cyanogram. And you can now see actually if we iterate very long, so after 1,000 updates, if you're close to the maximum likelihood solution, we actually get a lot of noise in our reconstructed image. And this is due to the fact that part of the noise of the measured data actually gets transferred into our reconstruction. So unfortunately, part of the noise in the cyanogram is consistent and gets reconstructed. Again, what we can do is we can smooth the images. And then I would say, for example, if you would apply 500 updates and a post-smoothing of 4.5 millimeters, we get a reasonable reconstruction. Of course, you should always keep in mind that the image quality is task-dependent. So for some tasks, you might say, okay, better resolution is more important and we tolerate more noise. For other applications, you might say, no, here we are really hindered by noise, so we will do more smoothing, but we will sacrifice more resolution. And if we decrease the number of collected counts in our measurement even more, so now we have 10 to the 6 counts, we can see there's way more noise on the measured cyanogram. And we can see here now, if you don't do any smoothing after 1,000 updates, so this is the maximum likelihood solution, or it's close to the maximum likelihood solution, the solution is very, very noisy, and I would say probably unusable for most clinical applications. So in that case, we definitely have to apply smoothing. And probably in that case, it also makes sense to stop the MLEM iteration early. So for example, here would say probably if we stop after 100 updates and we do a bit of post-smoothing, gives us a more usable reconstruction than iterating long and doing no post-smoothing. So what you should keep in mind is that we do MLEM reconstructions, we have to somehow do noise suppression because the acquired data in nuclear medicine scans, so in PET and inspect scans, is unfortunately very high. And there are different ways of suppressing the noise. So one way, as I showed you, is to just to stop the MLEM updates early. So not actually to iterate until convergence. And this is because noise is usually high frequent and the high frequencies converge slower than the low frequencies. Another strategy that is usually always used in combination with stopping early is to post-smooth our images a bit. So if you look what is implemented on most commercial scanners, you will always find that they use early stopped MLEM. The number of update depends a bit on the system generation, because MLEM or the convergence of MLM, for example, in PET depends on the time of light resolution, which will be, I think, part of another video. And a third way to do noise suppression is actually not to do maximum likelihood reconstruction, but more maximum a posteriori reconstruction. So in that approach, we would use a smoothing prior. So actually, you try to suppress certain solutions. For example, we could say we assume that the likelihood of all reconstructions is not the same. For example, we know that it's very unlikely that that neighboring voxels will show very different uptakes, which basically assumes that noisy solutions are unlikely. And then you can design certain smoothing priors that penalize those solutions. I think what you should keep in mind is that many people, I think, know that MLEM is used as the default reconstruction algorithm in most nuclear medicine scanners. But actually, we are never using the actual maximum likelihood solution, because at the noise levels of our data, the maximum likelihood solution is way too noisy, unfortunately. So what we usually do is we use early stopped post smooth MLEM, and that actually doesn't give you or doesn't result in the maximum likelihood solution.